binomial distribution. Now we are on the main topic. We have already gone through the Bernoulli's trial. Now basically what distribution is, let's do something different or an analytical approach. Okay, so now we are having, suppose we have done number of questions, okay, and the concept is very much clear about the tossing of a coin, what are the probabilities. Now suppose we are getting an head, then we are saying it is a success, we are getting a tail, it is saying failure, suppose. Okay, so now when a coin is tossed, we are getting either a head or a tail. So what we can do with that, let's discuss it. Now I'm just writing few lines. Now let H denotes the outcome, H, capital H, and that is what? Head. T denotes the outcome, tail. Now what is the probability for it one? Okay, we are having, now let probability for H is equal to P, we are just writing it a small p, okay, and this is denoted by success. Say success, okay, and probability of tail as Q, that is failure, P and Q, both the terms. Now we can write it, probability for a tail is equal to 1 minus probability for H. Probability for a tail, it is 1 minus probability for H. Or now can we write it, Q is equal to 1 minus P, and this implies P plus Q is equal to 1. Okay, this is what, this is the basic funda for writing it in the distribution form. Okay, basic things, because we have already discussed that for the probability distribution it was a discrete, and same thing we are going to repeat here but in the distribution form. Okay, so for the distribution we are having, we are taking only two things, that is success and a failure. Okay, now what I am doing, now suppose a coin is tossed twice. Okay, now example, let a coin is tossed twice and capital X is a random variable and it is in number of heads, number of heads. Now possible values of head, possible values of X better than head, it is 0, 1 and 2. Because we are having, let a coin is tossed twice, it means we are, what we will be getting, we will be getting sample space as, now sample space will be tail and tail, tail head, head tail and head head. This will be the sample space. Now if we are writing probability for X is equal to 0, we will be having probability for tail and tail. X is 0 because X is for the number of heads, we are having no head, it means tail and tail. So this becomes probability of a tail with probability of a tail. Now probability of a tail, what we have written, it is, we have written it is Q. Okay, so this becomes Q times Q and this is what, Q square. Now probability for X is equal to 1, this we are having TH or HT. To this one, what we can write it, probability of TH plus probability for HT, and this further probability of T times probability of H plus probability of H times probability of T. Now, this becomes QP plus PQ, or this is now we are having 2QP, sorry, not square, 2QP, I am sorry. Is it clear? QP plus QP. Now, probability for X is equal to 2, we are having probability for both the heads. Now, this will be what? Probability for H times probability for H. Now, this is P times P is equal to P square. So, basic thing is that we are getting, number 1, for P X is equal to 0, we got probability in this form. For P X is equal to 1, this form. P X is equal to 2, we get this form. Okay. So, now, let's put the values here. Now, X and probability for X. Here we are having 0, 1 and 2. Now, what 0 was? Q square. Q square, 2QP and P square. Okay. So, now probabilities are in which form? They are in which form? Just look. The probabilities form the term binomial expansion of Q plus P whole square. No, this is the binomial expansion for Q plus P whole square. This is this one. Okay. Now, cross check. In the cross check, what we are having? Q plus P whole square is equal to Q square plus 2QP plus P square. Now, what to cross check? What we are going to cross check? What is the probability actually for terms Q, what is the probability for a tail? When one coin is tossed, that is half. 1 upon 2 plus 1 upon 2 whole square. Well, half plus half is 1. Now, what about this Q square? This is 1 by 4. Q is 1 by 2 whole square, or you can write it. It is half whole square plus 2 times half times half. Plus half times square. Now, this becomes 1 by 4 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4. Now, this is 1 square. Now, 1 is equal to 1. So, basically what this is the binomial expansion, and when we are putting the probabilities in it, it becomes what? Binomial distribution. So, this is a something basic thing. When one coin is tossed, what we are getting? Similarly, when you are tossing a 3 coins, again Q plus P whole cube, that will be the possible result and it will be the accurate one. Okay. So, now we are going for a definition for a distribution, binomial distribution.